Frayer Model is a tool for teaching vocabulary in a very direct way. And it's a kind of a four-square model where the students write the word that they need to know, a really important vocabulary word. We call them depth words here at the school. And they write it in the middle of the Frayer Model. And then there are four different ways they connect with what the word means. With the definition, they learn the exact definition of the word. They draw a picture of the word, they use the word in a sentence, and then they make connections from this word to other content areas. I use the document in class by giving them all their own copy of a Frayer model, and then I either put the copy up on our TV screen for them to see as I write down each section, what goes in each section, or I use the board, and we do it on the board. I put a copy of this Frayer model on the board for us to look at today. So we talk through each area one at a time, and before we do the definition, I invite them to tell me what they think the definition means. And I try to take all of their definitions and weave them into the one that I really want for us to have. Paula said the word sphere. She says a planet has something to do with geometry. A planet is a sphere. Remember, a sphere is like what? Like a, everybody?
A ball.
Like a ball, right? So I like that. We're going to put all these definitions together and see what we can come up with. For the pictures, I ask for their ideas, and then I do a picture, but I let them have freedom to draw their own picture, what excites them, as long as it goes right back to the word. If we tie a picture to a definition, our brain has two things to hold on to remember the definition. I'm going to make an arrow going this way, and over here is the sun. That's the star that we orbit. And same thing with sentences. We brainstorm some sentences, and then in the end they write a sentence that makes sense to them. And then we all write down the same connections. I like the Frayer model because I've seen so much improvement in my students' ability to retain information. They can really recall the vocabulary words that I need them to know well, and we can go back to the Frayer model. We have a notebook we keep all of the pages in. They can go back and look at things and recall those words, and I've seen such an improvement in my vocabulary scores.
I like the Frayer model because there's lots of different ways that you can understand the word. Like, you have the word in the middle, and then you have four different examples so you can understand what the meaning of the word is.
My students like the Frayer model because they really enjoy knowing what a word means, exactly what it means. They enjoy drawing. I have a lot of artists in my class, and I know some of them connect to that. I have kids who are auditory learners, and so they can hear me say the definition, and they can write it down and remember it. They like being able to put it in the context of a sentence and kind of impress everybody by their knowledge. By the time they've learned the definition and drawn the picture, they're able to use it in a sentence. And then they love making the connections to other parts of their lives.